County, Sheriff.
Oh, how's every little thing, Ernest?
It's not too good.
Why?
That fool Cade is up a tree again. Fire Chief says he's sick and tired of going after him, and so we thought that maybe if you could...
All right. Where is he? Don't tell me it's the same tree.
Yeah, a tree across the house on L.
All right. I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Sheriff, state police on the phone, emergency. What happened? State prison lost a couple of boys. Dogs pick up the tracks just outside of Madrid.
Anybody we know?
Yeah. It's Johnny Graywolf and a young car thief named Frank Stubbock.
Who's in charge?
Captain Hoover.
Steve, Sam Cade.
Oh, Sam. Sam, I need your cooperation officially.
You got it.
What happened?
We don't know. They were working at the mill and just disappeared.
Where are the dogs?
South Fork of the Dolorosa, about a mile and a half into Madrid. Now, how many planes can you get me?
I'll give you two.
Good. All right, you take the grid east of Millersburg, north of Big Leaf and west of Coyote Flat. They're bound to funnel down through Dry Valley.
You see him heading for Mexico?
Well, sure, don't you?
Hey, what do you know about this Stubbock?
Well, not a whole lot, actually.
Frank Stubbock's been in trouble all his life. Nothing serious, petty theft mostly. The guy's a follower, a puppet. He'll do whatever the other guy tells him to.
Grey Wolf is the one you have to worry about.
I guess so.
I know so. He's a Comanche, an ex-deputy of mine. He pistol-whipped two prisoners to death in 1968.
Nice guy.
He knows every trick in the book. He also knows that Mexico will extradite him.
He'd run that risk anywhere, wouldn't he?
Not if he reached the turquoise curtain.
Sam, this is your territory, I know, and I'm not about to tell you how to run your end of the search, but
I've been over these badlands in a helicopter, and I'm here to tell you that not even a Comanche'd be crazy enough to try that route. Holy Land or no Holy Land. Now, trust me, Sam, he's going to aim for Mexico.
I'll try to have those planes in the air in 10 minutes. Let's go, Arlo.
Where are we going?
The curtain. Oh, Rudy.
Yes, sir.
Contact every ranch between here and Rim of the Sky and tell them that Grey Wolf is on the loose. And listen, one other thing. Contact the tribal police and tell them that I need a Comanche tracker.
Right.
I promised Hoover two planes.
I know, I heard. They just took off. I also heard you mention you might go poking into the curtain. You sure you know what you're doing? That place has been taboo to whites for 300 years.
I know. Could be that's what he's counting on.
Could be he'll start an Indian war if you go in there after him, too.
That's why I need special permission to go in there, so you better get started on those... Now, what's this?
It's your special authorization. It's already been checked through.
Nobody likes a smart head, J.J.
Will assign you a tracker named Tom Running Man. You pick him up at Wild Horses Lodge.
And send somebody up the big tree opposite Ernest Munson's house and bring his cat down.
Right.
Hey, John. How's this?
Deeper.
What are we looking for here? Gold? That was a joke, John. Well, I guess you'll tell me when you're good and ready, right? Boy, I bet that was about the slickest escape they ever had in this state. I bet they ain't figured it out yet, huh, John? What do you think? I believe we made it, buddy. So now, boy.
Take off your shoes. Bury him good.
She's off.
John? Why?
Because it'll hold up the dogs. It'll delay them a little bit from digging.
I don't hear no dogs, John.
You will.
Boy, this is really weird. I mean, I've been on my own ever since I can remember. Never knew my pa. Ran away from my mom, my aunts, when I was 6. I never needed anybody. Never trusted anybody. I trust you, John. Maybe I've been looking for somebody to trust all my life, huh? I still can't figure out why you took me along on a break, John, but I'm sure grateful you did. Why did you take me along?
Because where we're going, man can't make it alone.
Well, you could have picked anybody. You could have...
No. Had to be young, strong, and white. You had to be able to do things and get me places I couldn't. Had to follow every order I gave. You had to trust me.
Hey, this ain't so bad. Hey, they feel tough enough to take me clear to Mexico now.
Too bad. We won't be heading for Mexico.
Ain't heading to Mexico. Ain't going to Mexico. Well, where are we headed?
East.
To civilization.
The opposite. Into the mountains. My land. Indian land.
How long?
Forever. We find some wives, some women, bring them in if we have to. We hunt, we fish, we live free the way a man was intended to. No more real estate. Can't buy and sell the land. You can't buy and sell your mama. All right, boy, let's get out.
Well, won't the dogs just pick us right up again?
Not after they get a whiff of this.
What is it?
It's sage and orchard root. Better than pepper.
Why didn't we do this before, John?
I wanted to give them a direction. South. This will slow everybody down. Except for one man, maybe.
What man is that?
Oh, man. Just a man.
Stay tuned. Cade's County will return at Crime Stoppers.
Tell me something, Phil. What was the reaction of people around here when Grey Wolf escaped?
Joy.
Even for a killer?
For a Comanche killer. He's a link to the old legends. The kids don't care whether he's right or wrong. He's free.
Hmm. Well, it's the kids we have to worry about when we bring him back.
When you bring him in, Sheriff.
This is your tracker, Sam. Tom Running Man. Sheriff Cade, Deputy Pritchard.
You in some doubt, friend, as to whether we can bring this man back?
Some.
Well, you know, I'm not sure that's the kind of attitude.
Oh, wait a minute, Earl.
How long you been with the tribal police, Tom?
2 years. 2 years, sir.
I take it you don't approve of this assignment.
I don't approve of it at all. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm here. I'd like to get out of it.
You'd like to see Grey Wolf get away?
I would.
Why?
I'm sure, Sheriff, you would not understand.
Oh, maybe I would.
Okay. He's an Indian. He was caged. Now he's free. I approve of that.
He was caged for a reason.
So you say.
So said the courts.
White courts, white judge, white jury.
Would you help him get away?
Of course not.
You'll do.
Wait a minute.
wild horse.
You heard the man.
About them dogs.
Cover the window.
Yes, sir. This is real fine, Johnny. Chairs, bunks, all the comforts of home. How you know about these places?
It's my old stamping ground. I was born here, Frankie. I've been over this territory 100 times.
101 now.
101.
Boy, they must have been crazy thinking they could ever keep a man like you locked up.
White man crazy.
Like locking up the wind. Hey, Donnie. Tell me about the Indian country again.
I've been over that already.
We'll make it 101.
To begin with, it's a country without a fence.
No jails.
No fences, no jails, no laws. When you're hungry, you eat. There's berries there, big as your fist. There's wild horses, if you can catch them. Wild horses. Frankie boy, that's something. That is something, a wild horse. There's sweet grass to sleep in, lie on. There's water, fresh water. Yes.
What else? Hey, John. Hey, John. Hey, John, what is it?
That's a boot print, Frank.
Out here.
Sheriff's boot.
Well, how you know that?
I know. I've been looking for it all day. I never figured he'd come east. Quite a man. He's trying to cut us off, Frankie. He's quite a man for a white man.
Who are you talking about?
Oh, a fella I used to. A man I worked for. His name was Cade. Frankie boy, we're gonna have to make us a little detour. As I recall, seems to me there's a ranch up north a ways.
We headed up there? Why?
Pick us up a gun. Can't kill a man without a gun.
Yeah, I got it. We'll have somebody there in 10 minutes.
Yes, I will. Just a second.
Hold. Need a car at 5th and Rosita.
JJ.
It's Sam.
Hello, Sam.
Where are you?
Rim of the Sky Ranger Station. Any word from Hoover?
Word?
I figured you could hear him bellowing clear out there. His dog lost the scent last night.
Where?
About 6 miles south of Gila Bend.
Is Rudy still there?
Yes, Sam.
Were you able to contact all the ranches, Rudy, along the rim?
Well, all except one. Claiborne's didn't answer.
Any good reason?
Switchboard operator says they've been on vacation, due back tomorrow or the next day.
Uh-huh. All right, look, I think I'll check in with him anyway. Hey, JJ?
Yeah?
Hey, JJ, ask Hoover to release one of our planes.
I want a general sweep of the desert due east to where Hoover stopped.
Right.
Frank Stubbock, turn up yet? Dead or alive?
Not yet. Seems kind of strange, doesn't it?
All right. I'll call back whenever we get something definite. Meanwhile, keep trying the Claiborne Ranch.
What was that all about?
Which part?
The part about Frank Stubbock.
What do you think Johnny took Stubbock along for?
How would I know? What difference does it make? Maybe they were friends.
Johnny Greywolf never made a friend in his life without a reason.
You know, Pritchard, I just about had it with you.
Well, that's fine. Let's hold get it on right now. Now, come on, hold it, Arlo. Tell me something, Tom. Will you give me just one... Tom, listen to me. Will you give me just one justification for Greywolf's murders?
Just give me one, that's all.
I don't have to justify nothing. I don't know how bad he was provoked.
You know, you ought to start a new religion, man, with all that faith you got.
Oh, come on, cool it, Arlo. Let's catch the man and then argue, okay?
If he doesn't mind catching him.
Little old house, you may not be much, but you sure are comfortable.
I wish you'd explain to me just once why it is every time we get 20 miles away from this place, you right away want to turn around and come back.
Hush up a minute. I hear the phone. Oh, I've left it in the bedroom. Thank you.
All right, I'm coming. Hello? Hello?
Still no answer, JJ.
I'll try it again in 20 minutes.
Now, why do people do that? I'll get the rest of the stuff.
Aren't you glad to be home? With me? Just the two of us?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Why don't you sit down and take off your shoes? And I'll pour us a couple of nice cold beers.
Sure.
You couldn't make that four beers, could you, ma'am? Morning.
Yeah, I know. It's all right. Take it easy. Now, who are you and what do you want?
Well, we're just a couple of wayfarers on the road of life, Mr. Claiborne. A couple of hungry wayfarers.
Get the beer.
All right, Al. Come on. Al. Al.
You hold her. I'll get some food.
She ain't gonna hurt us.
She could run.
What if she does, let her?
No, she's come along.
Oh, no.
Well, why, Johnny?
Why? Because now they'll be able to track us. From here, she's insurance.
Anybody home?
Kind of careless leaving their door unlocked, ain't it?
Yeah.
Well, they must be away. They always leave their car parked out front when they're home.
Only two in the family, Tom?
Yeah. Hal and his wife. Her name's Roseanne.
Either one of them lame or crippled?
No.
Well, what's the problem, Sam?
Take a look at that.
Heel marks, huh?
Like somebody's been dragged across here.
The barn.
He's alive.
Let me check the phone.
Still works, Sam. It's his first mistake.
No, he doesn't make mistakes. If he were to pull a phone out, the central test board would light up like a Christmas tree. He wouldn't want any repair crew coming here, that's for sure.
Yeah, operator? This is Deputy Pritchard out to Claiborne Ranch. Look, there's been an accident. We need an ambulance out here.
How? What happened, amigo? Roseanne.
She's fine. She's okay.
Who did it, Hal? Two men.
Was one of them an Indian?
They had a double-barrel shotgun hanging on that wall.
Right here?
Yeah.
They took it with them.
I don't get it. If they wanted a car, they could steal it. If they wanted him out of the way, they could knock him on the head and tie him up. But why this?
Why does a cat break a mouse's back?
Call JJ and fill him in. Tell him we found the tracks. If they get as far as the curtain, Tom and I will go in after them.
I don't know, John. I don't think we can go much further. I told you.
This'll do. Get up.
Why?
Because they didn't put wings on this buggy. We're gonna have to climb that cliff all by ourselves.
Hey, Johnny? You mean her too?
Mm-hmm. That's what I mean.
But you said if I behaved myself, you'd let me go when we got to the mountain.
I lie quite a bit. I'm one of the worst liars you'll ever meet. Just don't believe a word I say.
He's kidding you.
And if I say no?
Then I'm gonna set this thing right in that pretty white squaw face and blow it off.
Johnny, for Pete's sake.
You're gonna kill me, aren't you, anyway, sooner or later?
No.
Another lie?
Maybe. But I'll tell you something that's true. I'm gonna kill you here, now. If you ain't out of that car in 3 seconds. 1, 2.
Stream would be easier.
Yeah, but would it be smarter?
You have a lot of respect for him, haven't you?
Oh, not for him. His instincts.
Yeah. Well, he's gonna instinctively murder Roseanne.
Hell, and she served her purpose.
What's that?
Well, he wants to hold us back. He wants to worry us. He'll kill Frank Stubbock when he's through with him. He's a loner.
He's a maniac.
Like a rattlesnake.
I can live in this land with rattlesnakes, but this man turns my stomach. It's been a terrible day for me, a strange day. I have a feeling you understand just about how terrible it's been. I'll pick up his track for you. It's abandoned, Mr. Cade.
Hold it.
Can't be far ahead now. He's getting careless.
No, careless isn't the word. A baby could have followed his trail the last mile or so.
Maybe he wants us in here.
Yeah.
That must have done it.
Maybe. Sun will be down soon. If anything moves on that gorge between now and then, kill it.
Where are you off to?
The curtain. It starts at the top of that mountain. We'll be safe there. That's where the old gods live. No white men allowed.
Yeah, but what about me?
With you, it's different. You'll be with me. I'll leave you a trail.
Put your hands behind your back. Come on, move. How's your arm?
It's busted up pretty bad.
What about the radio?
It's gone.
Your handgun?
Well, the firing pin's broken. A if I leave you alone with Stubbock. I give you this gun. Can you handle it?
Yes, sir.
JJ will be coming in here as soon as he knows our radio's gone.
Yeah, I hope.
Now, at sunset, I'm going to signal you with this mirror I have here. But if you don't see the signal, you tell JJ to come on in. War or no war. Stay loose.
Henry, don't you try to high and mighty me. I knew you when you was in Roppers. I'm not asking for the moon. All I want is authorization to send as many as Steve Hoover's state police through the turquoise curtain as I have to. I know it's holy ground. He ain't gonna subdivide it, he just... All right. Will you let me send a helicopter in? Your pilot and one deputy. Thank you, Henry.
Madrid control calling Unit 1. Unit 1, please. Madrid to Unit 1.
Still nothing?
Absolutely dead, Mr. Jackson.
Contact the airfield and tell them they can put one bird up. Rudy will go along.
Thank you. man, Cade. I smell you. Where are you?
TV Land's Crime Stoppers. Now stay tuned for our next TV Land Crime Stopper, New York City's hardcore undercover cop, Serpico, here on TV Land's Crime Stoppers.